He, you know, he led the nation in scoring and assists. And I thought with his handles, you thought he was going to be able to, he would struggle because he's so small getting that shot off. But when you got handles like that, you can get the spots before they beat you there. And so same thing with Kyrie, same thing with Steph Curry. Smallish guards, but can get that shot off against anybody. He's very impressive.
I never thought I would use the word efficient to describe a Trae Young game, but I will give you this. But remember, his three-point shooting was horrendous. His first year, 32%, 36% last year, which ranked only 91st. And remember, in defensive win shares a year ago, he ranked 325th. So that's still a big problem, as is the turnovers. He had four last night, which by his standards, not that bad. He was second to James Harden last year in turnovers.
No, Skip, he's always Skip. He's 5'11". Mm-hmm. So he ain't guarding anybody unless it's Isaiah Thomas II. Skip, what happened? Jamal Murray had fouled out late in the fourth quarter, so that's why he didn't finish the game. Okay. Right. But he was 1-for-9, 0-for-5 from three before fouling out. He was bad.
Well, guys, that is it for Undisputed. Merry Christmas, Skip Shannon. Lucky to work with you guys. We'll be back here Monday. Will the Cowboys pull it off? Have a safe and Merry Christmas, everyone.
Let's go, Lakers.
The Pelicans got a 14-point win on the road over the Raptors in their season opener, despite a quiet 15 points from Zion Williamson. Brandon Ingram led all scorers with 24, and J.J. Redick poured in an additional 23 off the bench for New Orleans. Zion did have a team-high 10 rebounds in his nearly 30 minutes of play. So, Shannon, step ahead. Will the Pelicans make the playoffs this season?
Man. Brandon Ingram looked good, 24-11-9, Skip. So if I were to look at the Western Conference, I think we got the major players. I think we Lakers, Clippers, Nuggets, Mavericks, Jazz, Trailblazers. Okay, Suns.
About that last team?
Yeah, Jerry, they didn't look good last night, did they? Whew. Suns, Pelicans, Grizzlies. Kings got a last-second win last night.
You neglected to mention the Spurs, who had a nice opening win.
Oh, man. Yeah, I forgot about the O'Broccoli. Skip, it's going to be tough. But again, you got the 7-10 play-in game, Skip. So I think, I'll be honest, Skip, they looked better last night. And I know it's one game, and I hate saying this, but I think they looked better last night than they did at any point in time last year. Now, maybe they weren't as up and down, Skip, and, you know, throwing half-court lobs and all that. But I thought as a basketball team, watching this game, I love Brandon Ingram. I love, you know, Zion is not a high volume. I mean, he's 7-9, Skip. Didn't attempt a three. A lot of his stuff going to come into play. It's going to be layup. It's going to be a lot of acrobatics, left hand, right hand. It's going to be a lot of that. I thought Lonzo Ball shot the ball extremely well, Skip. 4-8 from 3, 4-9 from the floor. Eric Bledsoe. I'm going to say they're going to I like what I saw. I like Stan Van Gundy. I'm going to say, Skip, I'm going to say they'll get the 8th seed. I'm going to say they'll get the 8th seed. They'll be 8-9. I'm going to say they'll get the 8th seed.
And I agree. And I agree with your takeaway from last night. I loved what I saw. I'm not the biggest Stan Van Gundy fan.
Yeah.
As a coach, I think he gets a little naggy, a little, a little irritable, always in a sour pussy mood, and it's sort of hard to live with. But he will nag you about the defensive end of the floor in a good way.
Yeah.
And I think he's got these kids at least turning their attention to the other end of the floor.
Yes.
And what impressed me was, wow. In the second half, they held the Raptors to 42 points. They held them to 99 for the game.
Yep.
That's pretty good because I respect the Raptors.
Yeah.
And I respect the Raptors' defensive scheme, their commitment to the defensive end. They're still a very good team that's very well coached. And look what happened in the third quarter. They were down, the Pelicans, 56-50 at halftime, and all of a sudden they just took off in the third quarter when I least expected it.
Yeah.
And they won this third quarter 38-22. And Brandon Ingram, who's an all-star, played like an all-star.
He played like an all-star.
He did. He scored 15 in the third quarter on 6 of 9 shots. And my man, Lonzo Ball, in the third quarter alone, if we could see what he did, he made not one or two. He made all three of his threes. And that was these are the biggest shots in the third quarter. Lonzo Ball, this is pretty deep over here. He shot it easy, effortlessly, like he meant it. And he pulled right up and took that one on a sort of a semi-break. And here we go again. And he said, you know what? I'm feeling pretty good. I got this.
Step back.
And guess what? Does that not look like a conventional shot to you from the right side of his face? He's not doing
He's shooting it with conviction, Skip. Yeah. And the thing is, I believe Brandon Ingram will be even better. Because he now, Skip, he's the unquestioned. There is no more Holiday. He's the guy.
True.
And last, and they're going to put the ball last second. He's going to have the ball in his hand to make play for himself or create something for Zion.
And my man Zion got off to a rocky start because he got in quick foul trouble. But he doesn't have an ego the size of his body. So he was okay with that. But what does he do? He only shoots 9 times for the game, but he makes 7 of them.
Yep.
He is as efficient a scorer as there is in the league. He was as efficient as there was all last year.
Yes.
If he had qualified, which he did not because he didn't play enough games, he would have set records for a high percentage of makes on field goals. Well, guess what? In his first 25 games in the NBA,
right,
he still scored the most points since Allen Iverson back in, what year was it, 96-97? 96-97. We're almost going on 25 years. Yep. So through 25 games, he scored the most points of any just 25 games because it's crossing over into the next year. He's hurt for a big part of last year. Since Allen Iverson. Okay, that's pretty great. And they added Steven Adams to do the windows, to do the dirty
work. Yes, yes.
So Zion very quietly had 15 and 10 rebounds, but Steven Adams jumped right in and he did his dirty work, right?
Yeah, he had
8 and 8. And so that works. And my God, B.I. got 9 rebounds and 11 assists. So he's pushing. He just needed a rebound for a triple-double and a big triple-double.
Yo, they got to do something about them free throws, though. You can't shoot 50% from the free throw line because what happened, it'll come back to bite you when you're in a close ball game.
Yeah. I'll buy that. But I still think you'll see that get better and better because what I do love is they made 45% of their threes because J.J. Redick is just a professional shooter.
Yep.
He's a professional three-point shooter. And look what he did. He made 6 of 11. And if Zion keeps making 4 a game and Brandon Ingram can make 3 and Bledsoe had a big, nice night. Drew Holiday had a big night.
4 of 8 from the 3-point line.
Skip,
if I play in the Pelicans, where y'all think J.J. Redick going? He running straight to the 3-point line.
But,
the
operative word is running. Skip, he is running.
He ain't running to get no layup. No. He ain't running to get no spot. He running to spot up to the 3.
But he's running like Reggie Miller ran.
Yes.
He's going to run off picks, and he's going to run, and he's going to run all night, and you better run with him.
Yeah, if somebody...
If he gets a half clean look, it's going to go.
It's going
in.
Up.
Yep.
And he's sprinting to the 3-point line. If it's a 3-on-1, Skip, he's not trying to fill the lane.
Yep.
He running to the 3-point line.
Okay. So to be objective about a team that I just can't take my eyes off, I will give you this: Toronto in the second half shot 3 of 22 from 3. Well, that'll usually just flat out get you
beat off you.
Okay. And that's what happened. But I still loved what I saw overall from this team. I love the commitment on the defensive end, and I'm seeing the 8 seed because, to your point, if you go with the chalk, Lakers, Clippers, Nuggets, then let's go down to Jazz, Mavericks. I'll give you the Trailblazers. I'm just not sure about them. Dame had a terrible opening night, but we'll see. They should be a bottom of the playoffs.
Suns.
The Suns are legit. They're coming. They're going to be tough, but if you look above them, are the Rockets not going to plunge? I think they're going to plunge. Yeah. Are the Thunder going to plunge without CP3, who's now obviously in Phoenix? I think they're going to plunge.
You like the Kings or the Wolves?
The Kings had a huge opening night. They stole one.
I don't know how they won that game, Skip.
Had a tip in at the end, but Harrison Barnes made a great play on Joker, just took it away from him on the inbounds.
The play of the game was De'Aaron Fox blocked Barton. Barton had a game that was going to put him up by 4.
He
blocks it, they go back the other way and get the layup, and then Joker
turns. It was a chase down in the lane.
Yes.
It was spectacular. They have talent.
But he seemed really casual with his skill. He was like, he go profile and Fox.
Okay. But they won a game, and they're going to be a factor.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't think the Warriors will be the factor. That
No.
So I'm going to dismiss them. The Spurs, they look like a playoff team. They look like a 7 seed last night. And so I still have the Pelicans in the 8 seed, but to your point, it's 7-10 play-in.
Right.
And the Pelicans will be in that mix.
Yes.
And I would not want to play the Pelicans in that mix. That's all I know.
Yeah, your Broccoli team looked okay last night.
They're pretty good. DeMar DeRozan, I'm not the biggest fan, but he was strong last night.
Yeah.